गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, लेट अस स्टार्ट ए न्यू चैप्टर मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. मेटल्स इज अ वेरी कॉमन टर्म एंड यू मस्ट ऑल्सो हैव स्टडीड समथिंग अबाउट मेटल्स इन लोअर क्लासेस. सो कैन यू टेल मी चिल्ड्रेन, व्हाट आर मेटल्स? यस, यू नो दैट मेटल्स मीन्स द एलिमेंट्स व्हिच पोसेसेस ए लस्टर, बट आर वी सपोज्ड टू कंसिडर दिस एज ए डेफिनेशन? No. In order to define the term metals, let us consider some examples. For example, you consider the element sodium. In 9th class, you have studied about the electronic configuration. So, on that basis, let us define metals. Sodium, you know that possesses the electronic configuration of 2, 8, 1. So, to attain stability, sodium wants to lose one electron. So, sodium, when it loses one electron, it forms sodium ion, Na+. Similarly, if you consider magnesium, to attain stability, magnesium generally loses two electrons and forms magnesium ion. Or if you consider aluminium, aluminium generally loses three electrons and forms aluminium ion. So, we can say that if it is a metal, it always shows a tendency to lose n electrons. This n can be generally 1, 2 or 3 and produces Mn+. N+ represents the number of electrons lost. So, children, metals can be defined as those group of elements which generally shows a tendency to lose electron and form electropositive ions. Is it clear? Elements which generally show a tendency to lose electron and form electropositive ions are termed as metals. Now let us consider some of the properties of metals. That is, first we are studying about the physical properties of metals. If you consider the first property, we can see that metals generally exist in solid state. That is, 95% to 98% of metals you can see as solids. So, metals generally exist in solid state. Okay, you know that mercury is an exception. Mercury is the only liquid metal at room temperature. Mercury exists as a liquid at room temperature. But there is another metal, that is gallium. If you take it in your body, if you keep it in your hand, it converts into liquid form. So that exists as a liquid at body temperature. But mercury is the only liquid metal which exists at room temperature. Second point, we can say that metals are generally hard in nature. Metals are generally hard in nature. Here also, children, some exceptions are like if you consider sodium. Sodium, we can just cut it with our nail also. So, it is so soft in nature, but generally metals are hard. As the third point, we can say that metals possesses high melting and boiling point. They generally have high melting and boiling point. You know, children, in case of metals, a special type of attractive force is present, that is termed as metallic bond. The attractive force, since I am not using the term bond, actually you haven't studied about any type of bond. But here we can say that the metals, you can see either type of interaction which is present in between the metal is termed as metallic bond, and this metallic bond exists actually between the positive nucleus of the metal, which is termed as kernel, and the negatively charged electrons which is placed around this kernel. Is it clear? So the attractive force which is placed between the positively charged kernel and the moving electrons is termed as metallic bond, and due to the strong metallic bond, they generally possesses high melting and boiling point. As the fourth point, we can see that metals generally have a luster, that is a shining surface, and that is termed as metallic luster. Metals generally possesses metallic luster. As the fifth property, we can say that metals, if you consider, you can convert them in the form of thin sheets. And this property of metals to get converted in the form of thin sheets is termed as malleability. Or we can say that metals are malleable in nature. At the same time, if you consider this malleable metals, gold and copper, gold is having the best, or it is considered as the best malleable metal. And the property of the metals to convert in the form of thin wires is termed as ductility. So, all metals are ductile in nature. You know, children, if you consider 1 gram of copper can be converted in the form of wire of 2 kilometer in length. So this property of conversion of metal in the form of wires is termed as ductility. 7, we can say that metals are very good conductors of heat. You know, for cooking purpose, generally we are depending on metals since they are very good conductors of heat. And the best conductor of heat is silver, and the second place we are giving it to copper. And lead and mercury are generally considered as bad conductors of heat. As the 8th property, we can say that metals are good conductors of electricity.